there, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Cadco Plays, the Vanishing of Ethan Carter Redux. We are in here now. Yeah, so the last thing we saw was Ethan and Travis. And Travis was trying to stop Ethan from burning down whatever room he has to burn down. And yeah, that was the last thing we saw. So, I don't know, this is the first time we've actually been in this building. But this whole time we've been wanting to do this. Yeah. Like 100 times the last episode you saw me try to open that door. So here we are now. I don't know what to do. So at this point now we've seen the fate of every single person in Ethan's family except for Grandpa and Ethan, which I think I mentioned last time. So we've seen Travis dead at the railroad. We've seen Chad dead at the cemetery church place. We've seen Dale dead just outside of this place. That was the last thing we saw. We saw Mom dead down in the mines. I think that covers everyone. But we haven't seen Grandpa. And something I realized between videos thinking was, even though I thought we took the scenes in the wrong order as the game would expect it, I feel like we've actually seen them pretty much in order of how they actually happened in the game. So I don't know, maybe we saw them in a good order. Because when Chad died, everybody was there, right? And then immediately they go down into the mines to kill Mom, and then out here to kill Dale, and then up to the tracks to kill Travis, which is actually where the game starts. So I guess that the Travis one we caught out of order, but it'd be really hard to catch that one in order, I think. So I guess we'll go out here now. I don't know what's out here. I didn't know we could get over here, but we can now because the game has opened that up for us. So we'll continue forward and see what's we're doing the water now. See if there's anything we can do over here. Don't think we can go on that. Okay, so that's a big dam. Jeez. Imagine if that thing broke? That's cool though. Anyway, it seems really weird that all this would exist for no reason though. Are we recording? Let me check. I'm self-conscious about that. Or not self-conscious, paranoid. We are, so okay. Let's go back in here. Surely there's a reason to be here. Let me make sure we can't go in this building. Nope. Okay. So what do we got going on here? We got these things. Oh! Turn. Tap A. Cool. Is there one of these at other ones? Yes. But this is the only one that's not, that is actually moving. Oh, we gotta save. I guess you can't see it, but where my face was, we got the little saving symbol. So I guess that's a good thing. Okay, so what does this do? Nothing? Oh, we're walking a little bit into the water now. That's cool. We got our feet wet. That's white. Sorry, I got a text. We can't do anything over here. So I don't know what that accomplishes for us. Again, it seems really weird to not have a reason to be over here. And also, I gotta think, like, at some point, Ethan and Travis and somehow Grandpa get from here way up to where we started this game at the railroad tracks. So, you think there'd be, like, a road or something there that was a little more direct, but I guess maybe they just take the elevator over there, but it seems weird for them to all be friendly taking the elevator together. So, I mean, you think that would have affected the water flow or something? These are stairs. They are. It looks like, actually, I can see the ground on this one a little bit. Maybe it could let us walk through the water here? Oh yeah! Check it out, guys. We've actually moved forward now. We are over here. I don't think I actually realized that you could get over here, so Glad I checked the water, because I was not actually trying to make it over here. Cool. Cool. So now maybe we'll, I don't know how many more scenes we could see. I'm thinking at most two. There'd be one if we saw Grandpa die, and then, the last one. But there's no one left to kill Grandpa except Ethan. It's literally just Grandpa and Ethan at this point, so yeah. Just explore and see what we can find. I'm pretty worried that I might have to cut this video in the middle of something and then come back, because I've got a lab that I've got to go.
I could feel a pinprick of light in the darkness. He would know me. He would know why I'd come.
Apparently Ethan is close. That means that he's also alive. He's gonna know me. Anyway, I was gonna say I have a lab, which is like a late evening lab, and I decided to start this up in hopes that I could get something meaningful done within like 30 to 40 minutes. Gotta hope that that's actually the case, though, or else I'll have to do some awkward cut in the middle where I go to lab and then come back and then finish something up. So, we are now in an entirely new place! This is different than everything we have seen. Well, I mean, not different in scenery, but just like this is the first time we've moved to like an actual new zone of this game, unless you count the first big bridge zone change, so cool, it's pretty. Sorry if I'm like been around a little too much. I said at the beginning of the last video that I had upped the quality. Well, I'm an idiot and didn't. I upped the quality if I was streaming, but not for recording, so it was the same. My issue with those recordings was the bitrate was a little too low, and so it didn't look good. I think it was watchable if you happen to want to watch the series, but it wasn't as crisp as I wanted. Unfortunately, it's just a part of... I should stop talking about that, because we just found this burned down house. This is... We've been hearing a bunch about Ethan wanting to burn down a room. Maybe he wanted to burn down a house. I thought it just said room. If this is what happened, then he successfully has burned this down. That is, that much is done, and I don't see a way into it for us to, like, look for clues. Oh, how about the front door? Well, let's check out here. We got these lion things. We'll head in. And it doesn't seem like we'll find anything, since it seems very burnt. But we'll look just in case. Aha! Sense.
I have to destroy the room.
Quartz. I'm sorry. Ethan. I can't let you do that.
Orvis. D. V. E. D. Okay, V. R. I'm trying to spell Corvus, I think. So this would need to be a C. C exists on this one? Yes, okay. C O R V E S. Corvus. Aha! Right? Nope. Oh, Corvus. Sorry. Okay, not Corvus, Corvus. That was easy. That was a lot easier than the Seagate thing. Okay, well, down we go. What are we about to find? May have picked the worst time to have to cut off in the middle. Oh, no. Shard. Peaceful. I tried to brick her up in the wall, but she fought me. In the end, I couldn't do it. Not to my wife. Neither she nor the sleeper is... Now I must decide whom I fear more. We don't have to piece anything together for this one. Oh, did you guys see who that was? I did. Totally Grandpa. Dang it. Okay. This is easy stuff. Oh. Oh, shit. I feel like stuff just hit me hard. So, do you remember back when we were backtracking to the beginning of the game and we found this newspaper thing near all the traps that talked about a house burning down? And I don't remember what names it was, but I ended up linking it to being Ethan's family. That house burning down and a grandmother being killed in it. One has to... Now this doesn't make 100% sense, but... Him, like, me finding that note right here and saying, tried to brick her up, but he couldn't do it. And then seeing Grandpa like this... I feel like there's a connection there, and all of a sudden you're thinking the woman, like his wife, is this sleeper somehow. Now that might be way off base. That could be 100% off base. So we will move forward here and see what happens. This has to be number one. Number two. Three. This seems really straightforward. Four. Try it.
Ethan, I fought it off. It's okay.
Grandpa, get away from me.
Your grandmother Gail is protecting me from it. Ethan, I can help you.
I found Vandergrift's diary. He said for the sleeper to wake up, someone has to suffer. Look. When I found that room, I didn't wake him up. He's trying to wake up now. Vandergrift kept his victims alive. He made them suffer. That's what the sleeper wants.
We need to get in that room.
I can squeeze through.
It has to be this way. The sleeper must not wake. Burning the room won't matter, Ethan. The sleeper's inside us now.
Grandpa! Get back!
We all have to die. Even you. Even me.
That Gail. So what I was just saying is obviously not correct. The grandmother wasn't in there. Maybe that was her. He was talking to this like it was her. But whatever happened here is not going to be happy. Oh no, it's not. Oh my god. Ethan.
Ethan, wake up. Well, kid, you stopped it. It was horrible, but you stopped it.
Paul Prospero? Are you really here?
I'm sorry, Ethan. I was late. Too late.
You're right. You were too late.
Here. Again. I knew this story. And it was Ethan's as much as it was mine. And it wasn't finished. Not yet.
Bridge. Dam. Church. Place. Stories. Traps and skulls. Space capsule. House of portals. Witch forest. Ancient god. All of them. Maybe this means we actually found them all as we went through this game. Yeah, cool. Good for us.
Christ, Ethan. You're in here again? You missed dinner. Mom and Dad are pissed. They've been looking all over the place.
Get out of here, Travis. Leave me alone.
Hey, Ma! He's in here! Honey, be careful with that lamp.
Dale, what the hell's wrong with your kid? Painting on walls, writing his stories. I mean, what the fuck?
Ethan! For God's sake, you missed dinner!
I'm sorry. I've been working on a story all day. How long have I been out here?
The Adventures of Paul Prospero, Supernatural Detective. Where do you get this stuff?
Pop, would you get Travis out of here, please?
He draws pictures on walls. What the hell is that?
Chad, shut up.
You got yourself a faggot for a son, Dale.
Travis, let's go. Come on.
Faggot! Ethan, you're a fucking faggot!
Travis, stop it!
Shit!
Everyone, go! Get out!
Ethan, get out! The smoke is toxic! Oh, God! What do we do? What do we do?
I wrote about you, but I don't know if I created you.
You made me real.
I can't go yet. I have to finish my story about you. I wrote stories about everyone.
I know you did, but my story's done, and it's a fine story.
I can let go?
You can let go.
What happens then?
Another story, kid. What else?
Well, guys, like we're at the end. Yeah, that's it. So, basically what just happened to us is it said that everything that we thought was real wasn't. All the stuff that had happened to this world that we just explored to play this game in was a part of Ethan's big story. What I noticed at the end was the personalities of each person in that last scene where they were yelling at Ethan or whatever to get out of the room and before the fire started, it matched things that we saw through the spirit sequences, the blue scenes. The dad was always the most caring, the grandpa sensible, also caring, but maybe not as sensitive as the dad was. Chad and Travis, jerks. Mom somewhere kind of in the middle. And I noticed at the end that last scene was, we saw the camera leave Ethan's room, go through the fire and up to where the family was. We saw Dad bringing Mom buckets of water. Dad also did kill Mom in our story by drowning her in water, right? Yeah. We saw Chad out with his head up against a post like this. Not sure. There was the scene where Ethan like pokes his eyes and then runs away, and Chad was in something similar. I'm not sure if that played into that somehow. You saw Grandpa hitting Travis, try to put a fire out from Travis, which is interesting because we saw Grandpa hit Travis twice, once to knock him down, cut the legs off, and then he hits him with a rock a couple times to kill him. So this is the alternate version where Grandpa is actually trying to save Travis, and that's also, I think, the weird point to that ending. All these times that we saw people, they were trying to kill Ethan, for the most part. Dale never really tried to. He was always kind of there, but like not quite strong enough to stop it. We never saw Grandpa try to until the very end. But at the end, everybody's trying to save him. So, it's interesting. This might merit a reflection video if I have time to leave and think about things and put it together. And maybe I'll watch some... I haven't thought about this until just now, but maybe I'll watch some other stuff and read up and see what some other opinions are and bring those together and do like a reflections finale type of video for this. But for now, this is the end of the Cadco Plays series. I hope that you enjoyed this if you watched it all the way through. Really appreciate it if you did. If you want to leave any comments on things you think I could do better in the future, please feel free to, or leave any other kind of comment that you'd like as well. I'll do some thinking on this game. I definitely enjoyed it. It took me 4 to 5 hours to beat it, which is, you know, pretty sensible. I wouldn't have wanted to go on much longer, but I think it wrapped up at a nice point. We actually ended up wrapping that up nicely too. It looked like I probably could have gone to that scene early in the game and then had to work my way back and finish all the other scenes and then come back. So it was cool that when we got there the first time that we actually got to see the ending. Definitely weird though. It's weird that the character we were playing wasn't real and then everything we did wasn't. So, interesting. Like I said, I might make a reflections video, but for now, this has been Cadco Plays The Vanishing of Ethan Carter Redux, and thank you for watching. Hope to catch you next time, maybe in another series, if you're down for it. See you then.